Hey, what's up guys, my name is Swapan Srivastava and welcome back to YouTube channel. So you all have seen the possibility with Android operating system, that how much powerful it can be, whether running the Windows 10 or heavy Linux distro, all is possible with the small tricks which you already seen in my previous videos. As you all know that Android is a Linux based operating system, so it holds all the capabilities of Linux. So for today's video, I'm going to use the Termex and I'm going to show you that how to use the Termex for installing the Windows 7 and running it on your Android phone. So this method is going to be one of the fastest method you ever seen, and this will be the one of the most smoothest way to experience the Windows operating system on your Android phone. It will not take a lot of time to boot up and it will not take a lot of time to function, so it will just a smooth experience with your smartphone and you will be easily able to run the Windows 7 on your smartphone. So it means that we are going to use the Termex as a shell, and with the help of that you are going to just provide some commands and it will just directly interact with the kernel of our Android operating system. And in the return, the kernel also give us some result which we'll be able to see with the help of the Termex. Okay, so I thought I'd take a lot of time in this intro, so let's start this video without wasting any more time. So here you can see guys, this is my smartphone and I am having the Asus Zenfone Max Pro M2, which is having the Snapdragon 660 and having the 4GB of RAM. So this is a mid-range phone, and it means that most of you might not have the any flagship killer phone like an OnePlus 8 Pro or Samsung Galaxy S2, and most of you might have the any mid-range phone like the Asus Zenfone Max Pro M2. So with the help of this phone, I'm just going to show you that whether this method is going to work very fluently on a smartphone or not. And believe me guys, that this method is going to be one of the fastest way to run the Windows 7 or Windows operating system on an Android phone. So first of all, go to the Play Store and search here for Termex. Here you can see this is a Termex app. Okay, so just download and install the Termex app from the Play Store. Now search for the other app, that is the VNC Viewer. Here you can see, so this is the VNC Viewer app and it will help us to connect to the remote desktop that I'm going to create with the help of the Termex app. Now you need to download and install an app called Geeky Drive. Just type here Geeky Geeky Drive. Here you can see. You will also find a download link of this app in the description. So in this app, I just written all the text tutorial of this video, and step by step I explained everything, and along with that I also just written the commands that you are going to use in this video. So this app is like in a tech news app, and you will get all the latest tech news from all the top sources of the world. And even you can search for any specific topic and it will give the latest article written in the all the top news sources of the world. Okay, so just download and install the Geeky Drive app. So the link is also given in the description. Okay, now let's go to the next app. So after downloading the Geeky Drive app, now just open the Termex app. Here you can see. So when it will open something like this. Now just go back to your home screen and launch the Geeky Drive app, and from here I'm just going you to open the full text tutorial of this video. From here just simply let me just reduce the brightness here. So from here simply to select the Geeky Drive option here, and here it will show some type of ad, so don't worry, just simply click on the close. It will close the ad. And from here simply click on these three buttons, and from here you will see there are a section of Windows on Android. Just select on it, and here you'll find the latest post on the how to run Windows 7 on Android using the Termex. So simply click on it. Now you can see this is the full text tutorial of this video with all the important description that you need to know. And you can see all the download links are required in this video, and you can see all the text tutorial step by step I explained everything for you. So if you're facing any problem in this video, just go to the app and just read all the article, and you simply need to just follow all the step given in this article. Okay, now first of all download Windows 7 file. For that simply select this link. Here you can see it will open some select it like this and copy it, and just go back to your home screen and open any web browser that you like. Now copy paste the link here. You can see I'm going to paste the link here and hit go. Now you're developing the page like this, and from here we'll see the download option for the Windows 7 file. So simply click on the download button. It will open something like this, and in the below menu you can see it is asking whether you want to download the file again or not. So I already downloaded it, I will not going to download it again. So just download the Windows 7 file from here, and the link is given in the Geeky Drive app. Here you can see I downloaded the Windows 7 file in my download section. You can see the size of the file is around 1 GB, 1.6 GB, you can see, and the path of this Windows 7 file is SD card download Windows 7. So just remember the path, it will going to be used in the next steps. Now go back. Now go back to the Geeky Drive app, just slide down. So here you'll find the first step to follow. First of all, open the Termux app and type the command apt update double and apt upgrade hyphen y. So just copy the command from here and open the Termux app and paste it here. So the command is very simple, apt update and apt upgrade hyphen y. Okay, so here you can see the update process is complete. So as I already updated it, so it will not update it again. So that's why it's showing that some type of error. But don't worry, for you it will update the Termux app. Go back to the Geeky Drive app. Here you can see, okay. Let me close all this. Now here you can see this is the second step to follow. So just copy the command here. That is pkg install qmu system i386 headless. You can see pkg install qmu system i386. Just click on the copy and open the Termux app and just paste it here and hit on the enter. Click on the y and hit enter. So it will start the download process for the QEMU. So I'm going to use the QEMU for this video. So it will install in the Termux, and after the installation I'm going to use the QEMU to launch the virtual machine containing the Windows 7 hard disk file. Okay, so later download process will complete and I will be back when this will be completed. Now you can see the download of QEMU is completed. So after that, let's go back to the Geeky Drive app, and the second step is already completed. Now go back to the third step. So now here just type the command Termux step storage setup storage. So just copy the command and go back to the Termux app and just paste it here, and it will just configure the your smartphone storage to be able to be detected inside the Termux app. So now it will open something like this. Just click on the allow. Now just type here ls. Here you can see it is showing the storage. This means that it will contain all the your smartphone internal or external storage details. You can see you will just type here lssd card, lssd storage. You can see these are the files which is contained inside your smartphone storage. So you can just access all the files from the Termux app. Now the next command or the next step is the just go back to the Geeky Drive. And you can see the third step already done. Now the fourth step is just download the Windows 7 file from the link given above. Okay, just go to the Geeky Drive and just copy the link that I shown you earlier. Just download the Windows 7 file. Okay, now let's go to the step number 5. Now it's saying that just remember the location of the Windows 7 file. So just go to your smartphone storage and see whether you pasted your Windows 7 file, and just go to the information of this file and just see where the location of this file is. So you can see, so this is the command that you need to copy. Just select this command, click on the copy, and now just go back to Termux app. Here you can see just paste the command here. Now after that, here you can see, so one thing you need to change here, and that thing is the location of the Windows 7 file that you downloaded earlier. In the my blog you will see the location is already set to some default value, but you need to change it to according to your Windows 7 file location. And one more thing I would like to tell you that about this keyboard, you also need to download and install this hacker's keyboard. It will help you a lot while typing the command for this method. Okay, just go to the Play Store and search here for the hacker's keyboard. So download and install this keyboard, so it will help you a lot while following this method. Okay, now just go back to the Termex, and here you can see you need to change the location of the Windows 7 file. So just read all the text from the Windows 7. Here you can see I deleted everything. Now I will type here HDA. I deleted by accidentally, and I will give the space here. Now just go to your smartphone file manager, open it. Here you can see I will go to my internal storage, and you can see in the download section, download folder, here is the my Windows 7 file. Okay, so what I will do, I will just go to information, and here you can see this is the path of the Windows 7 file. So I can't copy it from here, so I will simply just type all the path from here to the Termex app. Here you can see, so I will go back to the Termex app. You can see, and now I will type the location of the Windows 7 file. You can see /SD card, again /. Now the download folder name, that is the download here, and again the /. Now this location may be different for you, so just make sure that you type the correct location of the Windows 7 file, otherwise this method is not going to work. Now go back to the Termex. Here you can see I typed everything correctly. I click on the enter, and you can see no such file or directory. I think there is some issue in the command, not on the command, I think on the location. Okay, so I got the issue. The problem is with the Windows 7 file name. Here you can see it has the space between the Windows and 7. Here you can see that's why it's making the problem for the Termex app to detect the Windows 7 file. So for that, simply just go to the file name of the Windows 7 file, and from here just rename it. Just delete the space in between and click on the OK. Now go back to the Termex and just go to the place where Windows 7 is written, and just delete the space between Windows and 7. Now click on the enter. Now you can see it has started this VNC server, and now you have to go to the Geeky Drive app, and you can see you need to just follow the fifth instruction or fifth step here, and it says that you simply need to copy and paste this address to the VNC Viewer app. So just go to your home screen and just launch the VNC Viewer app. Here you can see, so this is the VNC Viewer app. Just open it, click on the next, and click on the get started. Now click on this plus icon. Now paste the address given in the Geeky Drive app. Now paste it here and just keep the name of your computer, and you can give any name. I'm just going to give here the name Windows 7. And click on the create. Now you can see it will show something like this. Just click on the connect, and it will say something like this, encrypted connection. Just simply click on the OK. Now it will say something like this, simply click on the skip for now. Now it will start Windows 7 on your smartphone. You can see it's showing the Windows is starting. Let me reduce the brightness of my phone. Now you can see it is started. Now it's showing the user icon. Now what I will do, I'm just going to double click on the user icon, and it will launch the desktop of the Windows 7. Okay, so double click on it. You can see it started the welcome screen. It's showing the welcome. So just wait here. So now you can see it is started the desktop of the Windows 7. So you can see this is the desktop of Windows 7. It's loading all the icons for you. Let me zoom up. Okay, so right now you can see easily. Here you will click on this mouse option. It will start the mouse feedback. Here you can simply click on this for the left click, and for the right click on this. And here you can see. Now let me open the start menu. You can see this is the start menu of the Windows 7. You can see it has the user Internet Explorer, email. Let me open the computer. Now you can see this is the my computer file of the my Windows 7. So here you can see it has the local disk C and all the normal files that you normally see, and here you can see the smoothness of the cursor. Now let me close the my computer here. Okay, let me open the Play Store here. Okay, so that's all guys for this video. And first of all, just make sure to download and install the Geeky Drive app. This is the my app, and in this app you will find all the latest technology news from all the top sources of the world, and even you can follow all the my text tutorial of the videos. Thanks guys for watching this video. I hope you like it, and if you have any doubt and any confusion, just comment down below. I will try to help you there, and even you can go to the description, find the link of my Instagram profile. Just go and follow me there. I will try to help you there also. So just thanks guys for watching this video. Have a good day and good luck, and bye, take care.